You talk about evolution. Because we're married and because we're in business together and we see each other literally every day, I think we have about 20 years of arguments already under our belt.
So there's growth. So let's talk about family.
Okay, it's all four.
Yeah, man. I mean, this is the core, and I think it's appropriate that we put this right smack dab in the middle of the show. When I think about family, you're a family man, you have five children. Mm-hmm. The first question I have is, you're in business with your wife.
Yes.
For a lot of people, that could be difficult, being in business with their wife. My wife and I, we're both entrepreneurs, but we're not necessarily in business together. Now, there are elements of business that we do together, but the main core businesses that we run, you know, we run those apart, and then the cool thing is we consult, right?
Yeah,
so it's like,
yeah.
I get her expertise, she gets my expertise. Cool. I won't hire a consultant or hire someone without her interviewing them.
Yeah, because you guys are getting a lot of knowledge in your own verticals.
Oh, yeah.
And then you guys can bring that back together.
But you all work together. Mm-hmm. So what are some of the things that you and Sheena have done to make that work? Because here's the other reality. Marriage is marriage.
Sure. Human being, male and female.
Yeah.
X,
and so
Y chromosome.
There are days that you're madly in love, and then there's other days that, you know, you're like, there she goes.
Step off.
Right, exactly, right. So just share a little bit with us about that dynamic.
You know, I think conflict and arguments are healthy, you know?
How about that?
Yeah, I think they are. I mean, if things were just, you know, in other words, we're both voicing our opinion, and we happen to be both, you know, A-type personality. She's a lot more organized and structured than I am. And on mine, I'm a lot more creative on my end. So through the process of building a business together, we are able to find our individual strengths.
Mm.
And then we also have a mentor that pulls us up too as well. So just like I have an accountability partner in the gym, we got an accountability partner in business.
So that kind of helps level things out at times?
Oh, big time. And sometimes we ask questions to our mentor because, you know, sometimes we may not listen to each other, but we'll listen to our mentor.
Ah. So then there's an objective third. What I'm hearing is there's an objective third party that both of you all respect.
Yes.
That when you're doing business and there's some type of business agreement, you can take that somewhere else. And then at that point, it's like, okay.
Mm-hmm.
I'm guessing you're not like, yeah, see, I told you.
Yeah. And sometimes, you know, and I've learned, for example, we got into an argument yesterday.
Okay.
She says, babe, you kind of snapped at me. I didn't snap at you. No, you snapped at me. Okay, forget how I'm feeling. You felt like I snapped at you? She says, yeah, well, babe, I don't think I did, but listen, if you thought I snapped at you, I apologize, I'm sorry. Four or five years ago, that wasn't, man, I had to prove myself right. I'm the man.
Right.
I'm not wrong, I'm right.
Okay.
Versus, you know what, if I'm serving my queen, if she felt, regardless, if I felt a certain way, if she felt it, then that's important.
Got it.
Regardless of how I feel.
And let me tell you, that's probably the toughest thing in marriage.
Well,
I love that because what I heard is that you were actually acknowledging the feeling and then apologizing for the impact that your actions had on her that created the feeling.
Right, because we naturally want to defend ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
That's a natural thing for us physically, emotionally, mentally, things that, like there's things that she's probably grown up with I'll probably never know about, which makes her the person that she is today.
Yeah.
And I have to honor and respect that and vice versa. And there's certain things that I need as a man. To feel loved and respected, that I need to remind her, hey, babe, listen, in this situation, would you consider doing this?
Makes a lot of sense. So I'm curious about how your marriage has and how it's evolved with the business. And the reason I'm asking this question is because I know for Pam and I, the first 2 years were tough. So I'm curious, like, how have you all evolved and what advice would you give to young couples who are looking to build? Yeah. I mean, they're listening, they're watching, and they're looking to build their business together. Or maybe they have two separate businesses and they're looking to build.
Yeah.
What are some of the things that you and Sheena do? Like let's call it the ingredients or maybe the components that you all use to stabilize your relationship.
If this is the person that you're going to date, for me, my situation was I'm a single dad. I had three kids. Sheena was a single mom. She had one kid. So we're a blended family.
Blended. Okay.
And so for 12 years, I dated my business. I wasn't dating anybody. So I lived for 12 years, didn't really date, right? So I was just dating the business. I was involved in the business. I was loving on the business, right? And then now we get married. Now I got to love on my wife. And I got to feel I got to remove my priorities and put it there. And you talk about evolution. Because we're married and because we're in business together and we see each other literally every day, I think we have about 20 years of arguments already under a belt.
So there's growth.
Huge. Hyperspeed.
Yeah.
Hyperspeed.
I mean, I think people forget that. I mean, everybody married that's listening, when you say argue, they're like, yeah. And I think sometimes there are people who are single who are out here that follow you and Sheena, and they see the bright lights and the stars, and you guys are smiling and hugging. And it's like, yeah, babe. They're like, they argue?
Oh, yeah.
This is
like,
real.
Like 30 minutes ago.
Yeah, exactly, right? So you argue, and what I love about that is you're like, it's grown your relationship hyperspeed. And so it's almost like you've been together 20 years because you've been able to cover so much ground.
Right.
Because you're confronting one another.
Yeah.
Would you say that confronting one another is one of the elements that has solidified and strengthened your relationship?
Yeah. Yeah. Managing conflict and processing issues quickly. Because if you don't process issues and manage conflict quickly, it'll ruin your day. And if you're in business, it'll throw off your sales calls. It'll throw off your presentations. It'll throw off your boardroom conversations. You'll loathe the business. Because you loathe her.
Right. And you're in business together.
And you're business together.
Yeah.
And
people, and then your team, because you're both leaders in the business.
Right.
Then your team can feel the energy, right?
Uh-huh.
Matt walks into the room. Sheena doesn't look at him. They're like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
Something going on.
And the immature entrepreneur will try to share their problems with their staff, with their team, and try to recruit them in their corner to pit them against the other partner.
Right.
Right? That makes no sense. Now you create drama in the office. People are like, I already got my own drama. I don't need your drama.
Now I
got
to deal with your drama.
Yeah, forget this.
Right.
That's not fair to them.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Our game is, if I'm serving you, right? If I'm your employer or if I'm coaching and mentoring you, then I need to bring you up to the next level. I don't need to make my job harder.
Mm-hmm.
By sprinkling my own crap in your lawn.
I love that. So one of the structures is communication. Yeah. Let's just take that, right? So hardcore communication, whether it's loving, whether it's confrontational with love.
And you don't need to be right all the time, right?
Say that again.
You don't need to be right all the time.
Because as a coach, one of the things I work with on my clients and one of the things we've talked about on the show is the cognitive distortions that many of us have.
Good word.
I mean,
cognitive distortion.
Mental illusions.
Yeah, right.
Right? I mean, we look at the world through this lens that's not really real.
Yeah.
And one of those lenses is, if I'm not right, I'm losing. And that's an illusion that will wreck your life. Mm-hmm. It will wreck your relationship. And it will wreck your business.
Mm-hmm.
And what I hear you saying is, look, man, I'm willing to take that lens off and actually look objectively at what's going on. And if I'm wrong, I'm wrong.
And that's usually anchored and sourced with pride and ego. And sometimes pride gets in our way. I mean, you want to take pride in your work. You want to be prideful about who you are, what your brand you represent, and the last name that you have. But when pride and ego comes to be negative and toxic and it just becomes selfish, then that's when you know it's not pulling you in the right direction.
Got it. So based on communication, what is you all like? Do you all have a cadence for meeting?
For me, I have a couple rules when I sit down with folks. So the only reason I'm going to ever pick up the phone is if I see my wife call back twice.
So you actually tell them?
Yeah, up front.
I love that.
Yeah. And my kids are calling me and they call back twice.
Mm-hmm.
And then my mentor. So if any of those calls come up, and it'd be a quick glance, because I don't want to take attention off the client, because I don't want them snapping the end, because there's always energy.
But it's beautiful because you've already set the tone.
Yeah.
So they know if you pick up the phone, Matt's handling an emergency. With his family, with the most important people in his life.
You got to manage the expectations up front. As I got to know my wife, I needed to share with her some of the things of my past that probably I wasn't happy with, because that's me, right? And so, hey, babe, listen, there's a couple things that you need to know about me, I don't want, because of the social media world that it is today, I don't want somebody putting a post up from 20 years ago that before social media was even created, somebody scanned an old picture from the whatever, and she may not like, right?
The visual,
right? And so I this is my life. Please don't judge me. Please judge me from the day I met you and how I treated you, because you changed my life.
That's huge.
Right? So just know this. So managing expectations up front with not only your life partner, your children, but also your business. The best way to go process conflict is to let people know the stuff up front. And asking the tough questions, letting people know the tough questions up front. How do you feel about marriage? How do you feel about kids? How do you feel about the D word? I've never mentioned the D word. You know what I'm talking about in terms of marriage. I don't even mention right now I'm on the radio, because I don't think that word has any place in my life. I don't want to give it one ounce of life.
Yeah.
The D word.
I love that, because what I'm hearing is commitment. Yeah. Like, I'm in. One of the things I hear is that with your wife, the most important person in your life, you've managed the expectation. Like, no matter what happens, I'm here.
Right.
We together.
Right. Right. It's funny. We're talking about commitment to our physical mm-hmm. and our health.
Yep.
And how we also have a commitment to our family.
Kind of similar, huh?
Yeah.
And that's interesting. Yeah. You share.
Yeah,
I mean,
quality, yeah.
What I'm catching from this conversation is that you as a leader, you've made some hardcore commitments.
Gotta be hardcore.
And they're commitments that you're not willing to breach.
Non-negotiables.
Would you say that has a huge deal to do with your success?
100%. These are certain non-negotiables in my life. There's no negotiation.
So what would you say to the person that's constantly negotiating?
It's like being on a boat without a rudder.
Mm.
And the storms catching you, you know, sloshing you left and right. And by the way, a lot of life is dealing with the storms. There's a lot more storms in life than there are sunny days. And if you don't have your anchors down, you're going to be knocked left and right.
Wow. So, I mean, what I'm taking away from this first part is that you're a committed man. You've dropped anchors in certain areas of your life. Mm-hmm. And you've used those anchors to stabilize you and to stabilize your relationship. But what anchor has Matt Sapaula dropped in finance? I got a couple of fun questions, though.
Sure.
As we kind of close out the hour. First, what do you want to say to your wife? I'm sure she's listening. What do you want to say to your wife right
now? Good morning, baby. Listen, I love the mother that you are, the wife that you are, the partner that you are, and I'm fighting every day to create a better life for us.